In order to find the moment of inertia about an axis parallel to the centroidal axis of an object, we can utilize the parallel axis theorem, that is, summation of moment of inertia about the centroidal axis and the product between the area of an object times the square of perpendicular distance between the centroidal axis and the axis along which we are calculating the moment. Here we are given a composite shape that is made out of three rectangles, so we can calculate the moment of inertia for each one of them and then add them up together to calculate our total moment of inertia about the y-axis. So to start, segment 1 has the dimensions of 1 inch by 8 inch. So let's first calculate the moment of inertia about its centroidal axis. The formula for that is 1 over 12 bh cubed. Here the value of b will be 8 inches since that dimension is parallel to the y-axis across which we are calculating the moment of inertia. Plugging the values in the formula give us the number 0.667 inch raised to power 4. Next, we have to project this thing along the y-axis. So utilizing our parallel axis theorem, we have to identify the distance between the centroid of the rectangle to the y-axis. In this case, the value is coming 9.5 inches. So plugging it in our formula, we are getting a value of 722.67 inch raised to power 4. That is the moment of inertia of segment 1 about the y-axis. Now let's look at our segment 2. Here, the dimensions of the segment 2 is 8 by 1 inches. Now, again, first thing we have to do is calculate the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis of this segment. Here, the value of base will be 1 inches as it is parallel to the y-axis, whereas 8 inches is the dimension that is perpendicular to the y-axis that will be the height of the rectangle. The value of the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis is coming 42.66 inch raised to power 4. Next, we have to figure out the distance between the centroid of this individual rectangle to the y-axis, that is coming 5 inches. Plugging those values in the formula, we get the value of moment of inertia of this rectangle about the y-axis equals to 242.67 inch raised to power 4. Finally, we have our segment 3 having the dimensions of 3 inches by 1 inches. Calculating the moment of inertia of this rectangle about the centroidal axis gave us the value of 0.25. Now, the distance between the centroid of this rectangle to the y-axis is 0.5 inches. So, taking the square of that 0.5 and multiplying with the area and adding up that with our moment of inertia about the centroidal axis gave us its value about our y-axis. Now, once we have all the individual moment of inertia of three segments, we can add them up together to calculate the total value that is coming 966.34 inch raised to power 4.